Today we are going to solve the MCQ based on the trigonometric functions. So in the last lecture we solved the two MCQ. In this lecture see the next MCQ. If x plus y is equal to 1, product xy gives 2, then find the value of tan inverse x plus tan inverse y. So this type of question we have to solve by using the trig directly. And we know that also use the identity. We know that tan inverse x plus tan inverse y. याचे आपण काय केले, दोन फॉर्म्युले एक्सप्रेस केले. But they depends on the condition of product xy. Okay? So see here, in that case we have to give the product xy is 2. But in this problem product xy is a greater than 1. Okay? So use the property tan inverse x plus tan inverse y is equal to, we can write pi plus tan inverse x plus y divided by 1 minus xy. So in the given information, we have to give the value of x plus y and product xy. So put both the values. In that case, we get pi plus tan inverse in bracket value of x plus y is 1 divided by 1 minus product xy is 2. Okay, so pi plus tan inverse. Difference between these two terms is minus 1. So we can write pi plus tan inverse minus 1. So in that case, we use the second property. We know that tan inverse of minus x is equal to minus tan inverse x. Okay. So use this property. In that case, we get pi minus tan inverse 1. Okay, so we know that tan inverse of something gives the angle, and that angle is a pi by 4. So pi minus pi by 4, take a difference between these two terms is 3 pi divided by 4. So the correct option of this question is B, and that is 3 pi divided by 4. So first of all, write down this problem. Then, see the fourth question is, if sin inverse 1 minus x plus 2 sin inverse x is equal to pi by 2, then find the value of x. So, for finding the value of x, we have to solve the given condition. Otherwise, we check the given condition by option. Okay? So, see the fourth question. Check with option. Check with option. The first option is value of x. R 0 and minus half. First of all, put the value of x in 0 in the given condition. We get sin inverse 1 minus 0. 1 minus 0 plus 2 times sin inverse 0. So simplify this. We can write sin inverse 1 plus 2 sin inverse 0. Okay, so we know that the value of sin inverse 1 is pi by 2 plus 2 times 0. We get pi by 2. So in that case, 0 is satisfying the given condition, but also put the value of x is minus half. So putting the value of x is minus half, we can write sin inverse. See here, sin inverse in bracket 1 minus half, take plus sign, half. plus 2 times sine inverse minus half. Okay, but see here, in that case the sum of this number gives the number 3/2, and decimal point of this ratio of these two terms is get 1.5. Okay, but we know that the domain of sine inverse function is a function from closed interval -1 to 1 to closed interval -π/2 to π/2. So this value is not included in the domain of sine inverse function. So this condition is not valid for value minus half. So it is the wrong option. Then see the option B, 0, satisfying this condition, but put the value of x is 1. So x is equal to 1. Put in this condition, we can write sine inverse 1 minus 1 is 0 plus 2 times sine inverse 1. Okay, simplify this, sine inverse 0 is 0 plus 2 times sine inverse 1 gives the angle π/2. So π/2 will get cancelled. Sum of these two terms is get pi. So this option is also wrong. In that case, put the value of 0. 0 is satisfying this condition. But see our last option. Here is the value of x is minus 1. Put in that case value minus 1. We get the number 1 minus of minus 1 gives the 2. But 2 is not included in the domain of these inverse functions. So this value is not valid for given condition. So the correct option of this MCQ is x is equal to 0. Okay. Now let's see the third question. The third question is the value of sine inverse 12/13 minus sine inverse 3/5. It is the given condition for finding the value of sine inverse 12/13 minus sine inverse 3/5. So in that case, consider 12/13 is x and 3/5 is 1. And in that case, use the identity directly. We know that sine inverse x minus sine inverse y, we can write sine inverse x root 1 minus y square. Take a minus sign into, sorry, minus y root 1 minus x square. But in this problem, value of x is 12/13 and value of y is 3/5. So use the identity directly. We can write sine inverse in bracket x. Here x is 12/13 into root of value 1 minus y square. Y square is 3/5 square is 9/25. Here is the minus sign. We take minus sign into, sorry, y. Value of y is 3/5 into root of value 1 minus x square. Here x is 12/13. 12/13 is 144 divided by 13 square, 169. Okay. Now first of all, simplify this bracket. We can write sine inverse 12/13, take as it is, into. See, the LCM of these two terms is 25, and difference between, take a cross multiplication, 25 minus 9, we can write 16. Okay. minus 3 by 5 into LCM of this two term is 169. Take a cross multiplication, 169 minus 144. Okay. Now again simplify this bracket. We can write sine inverse 12 by 13 into square root of this term is 4 by 5 minus 3 by 5 into difference between these two term is 25. So here we can write directly 169 minus 144. Difference between these two term is 25. Take a square root of 25 is 5 divided by 30. Okay. Now we get sine inverse. Sine inverse in bracket product of these two term is 48 divided by 65 minus 15 divided by 65. So LCM of these two term is sine inverse 65. Difference between 48 minus 15 we can write 33. But see the your options. In your options, sine inverse 33 by 65 is not included in all the options. So first we transform this function to the cos trigonometry, and we know that this triangle, here is the angle x, and put sine inverse of 33 by 65 is x, we get sine x is equal to 33 by 65, and we know that sine gives the value of opposite side is 33 upon hypotenuse is 65, and in that case use the Pythagoras theorem, we get the remaining side of this triangle is 56. So we write sine inverse to the cos inverse. Cos inverse of adjacent side, adjacent side is 56 divided by hypotenuse is also 65. But this option is also not included in the four options. So again we use the property. We know that the property sine inverse x plus cos inverse x, and sum of these two inverse function get the angle pi by 2. So we can write cos inverse x is equal to pi by 2 minus sine inverse x. Okay, so use this property, but here value of x is 56 by 65, so we can write pi by 2 minus sine inverse 56 upon 65. So see, this is the our option D is pi by 2 minus sine inverse 56 by 65. It is the correct option. Okay. Now let's see the next question is, if x, y, z are in AP and tan inverse x, tan inverse y, tan inverse z are also in AP, then find the relation between x, y and z. So for solving this question, we know that in arithmetic progression, y is the arithmetic mean of x and z. Okay. So in question number 6, given information is x, y, z are in AP. So we take two times middle term is equal to sum of first and third term. Otherwise, y is arithmetic mean of x and z. Okay, so x plus z divided by 2 is the value of y. So simplify this, we can write 2y is equal to x plus z. So also give the tan inverse x, tan inverse y, tan inverse z. The these three are also arithmetic progression. That is, we can write R A A P. Okay, so we can write 2 tan inverse y is equal to tan inverse of first term is x plus tan inverse of third term is z. Otherwise, we take the tan inverse y is the arithmetic mean of tan inverse x and tan inverse z. Okay, so in that case, we use the property. We know that tan inverse of y is equivalent to tan inverse. In that case, take 2y divided by 1 minus y square. And here, we use the next second property, tan inverse x plus tan inverse z. We can write tan inverse x plus z divided by 1 minus x z. Okay, so otherwise equating both term, otherwise take a tan trigonometry on the both side. We can write 2y divided by 1 minus y square is equal to x plus z divided by 1 minus xz. See here, but we know that the value of 2y, value of 2y is x plus z. Put this value in that case. We can write x plus z divided by 1 minus y square is equal to x plus z divided by 1 minus x square. Okay? So, but in that case, we cannot cancel the value of x plus z or x plus z. Because just me a value cancel kara. Tare aapala ya equation cha see here ya equation cha complete solution ya tikani milnar nahi. Tyamu apan variable cha ja terms ahe te ya tikani cancel karu shakat nahi. So take all term on the left hand side. Take a common factor of this two term is x plus z. In bracket we can write 1 minus 1 minus y square, 1 divided by 1 minus y square minus 1 divided by 1 minus xz is equal to 0. So, in that case, product of these two terms is gives 0. So, either first bracket is 0, otherwise second bracket is 0. So, we can write x plus z is equal to 0 or second bracket is 1 upon 1 minus y square minus 1 upon 1 minus xz is equal to 0. So simplify this, we get the value of x is minus 0. So for second condition, we can write, see here, 1 divided by 1 minus y square minus 1 divided by 1 minus xz gives the value 0. So simplify this two term, we can write 1 by 1 minus y square is equal to 1 divided by 1 minus x2. Take a cross multiplication, we get 1 minus xz is equal to 1 minus y2. This plus 1 term will get cancelled, minus sign also cancel. We get y square is equal to xz, and that is, we know that the x, y, z are in GP. So here x, y, z are in GP. So in that case, the x, y, z are also in GP or x, y, z are in AP. But see here, jabhi x, y, z tumche AP ani GP doni cha condition satisfy karta, tyamule te tumche x, y and z are the same. See here, that is x, y, z is equal to 1. Both x is equal to 1, y is equal to 1 or z is equal to 1. Otherwise, value of x is 2, y is also 2 and z is also 2. So, in that case, see the option first. In this option, value of x is equal to y is equal to z. And this option is satisfying the both condition, that is 2y is equal to x plus z, or y square is equal to x square. So it is the correct option. Okay. Now see the next question. For finding the value of this condition, here we have to give the tan. In the question number 7, tan of in bracket 2 tan inverse 1 by 5 minus 5 divided by 4. So, for solving this type of a question, first, here is the tan trigonometry. So, first we transform this bracket to the tan inverse. म्हणजे बाहेरची trigonometry आहे त्याच्याच inverse trigonometry मध्ये तुम्हाला हा bracket काय करावा लागतो transform करावा लागतो. तर त्यासाठी या ठिकाणी 2 tan inverse आहे. म्हणजे आपण property use करू शकतो 2 tan inverse x and we can write the value of pi by 4 in terms of a tan. So, we can write tan taken as it is. So, here is the 2 tan inverse x. We can write tan inverse 2x. But 2 into value of x is 1 by 5 divided by 1 minus x square. Here x is a 1 by 5. 1 by 5 square is a 1 by 25. Minus pi by 4. We can write in terms of a tan inverse. It is a tan inverse of 1. And we know that tan inverse 1 gives the angle pi by 4. So, then after simplifying this bracket, we can write tan of tan inverse. It is 2 by 5 whole term divided by. See the difference between these two terms. First, we write the LCM is 25, cross multiplication is 25 minus 1. We can write 24 minus tan inverse 1 is as it is. Okay. Now see tan inverse. Sorry, tan of in bracket. Simplify this term. We can write tan inverse in bracket 2 by 5 cross multiply by 25 divided by 24 minus tan inverse take tan inverse 1 take as it is. Okay. Now simplify this bracket. 5 are 25, then 2 12s are 24. Okay, now see tan inverse in bracket we can write tan inverse. We get 5 by 12 minus tan inverse 1. Okay, now see. In that case, we have to use the property. We know that tan inverse x minus tan inverse y. Tan inverse, sorry, here is the tan function. Tan in bracket. Tan inverse x minus tan inverse y. We can write tan inverse x minus y. Here x is 5 by 12. Y is 1. Whole term divided by 1 minus xy. Here x is 5 by 12 and y is also 1. So, first of all, simplify this bracket. We get tan of in bracket tan inverse. We can write here difference between these two terms. LCM is 12 and 5 minus 12. Take a cross multiplication. 5 minus 12 get minus 7. Whole term divided by LCM of these two term is also 12. Take a cross multiplication. 12 minus, here is the value, 12 minus also use the property. We know that tan of tan inverse x, we can write x, but here x is minus 7 divided by 7. So see, our D option is minus 7 by 17. It is the correct answer. Now see, our next question is cos inverse, if cos inverse x minus cos inverse y by 2 is equal to alpha, then find. There is the F, if 4x square minus 4xy cos alpha plus y square is equal to. Okay, so for solving this type of a question, we have to use two types of a property. So see, the first property is, we know cos inverse x minus cos inverse y. We can use the property cos inverse x minus cos inverse y. We can write cos inverse. We know that it's a product of x, y. Cos A cos B, that is xy minus, here is the minus y, minus sign, so take plus sign, root of value 1 minus x square into root of value 1 minus y square. Okay, so use this property. Otherwise, we know that the another reason, if cos inverse of x by A minus cos inverse of y by B is equal to theta, then we know that the value of square of this term is x square by a square minus 2 times, the product of these two term is xy by ab into cos theta plus square of this bracket is y square by b square is equal to sin square theta. So use this result directly. We can find the value of 4x square minus 4xy cos alpha plus y square. So in the given example, here give the cos inverse x, that is the value of a is 1, minus cos inverse y by 2, in that case value of b is 2. So use this result. We can write x square by a square, that is x square by 1 square is 1, minus 2 times, take the product of these two terms is xy divided by 2, okay, into is equal to, we have to give the alpha, so take here theta is given alpha, so we can write cos alpha plus square of this bracket is y square by 4 is equal to sin square alpha. So simplify the left hand side. Here two term you can cancel, x square minus xy cos alpha plus y square by 4 is equal to sin square alpha. So take the LCM of this three term is 4, and take a cross multiplication, 4x square minus 4xy cos alpha plus y square is equal to sin square alpha. So for finding this value, we can write 4x square minus 4xy cos alpha